Hello, we're back. It's week two. It's week two, and the dramas continue. We've had characters coming and going. We've had fledging. We've had some consuming others, and we've had some being regurgitated, but less said about that, the better. Now, with all this and more going on, there's plenty to digest in tonight's Springwatch Unsprung. Audience we've got. We've got a super audience. We've got more than capable Laura, and we've got a diverse audience because we've got everyone from the county bird recorder. Where's Steve Abbott? Where is he? There he is. Steve Abbott over there. And over there we have Becca. She's a member of our team. She's the chocolate fairy. Every time I'm feeling her sugar levels dropping, she sneaks chocolate into my caravan. She's a very important part of this. So, without further ado, we should probably get on. Now, we have had a weekend off. OK, we've had a weekend off, but not all of you, and the wildlife, it seems, certainly haven't. You have been incredibly busy, and as a consequence of your busyness, you've been sending in so much stuff, lots of queries and questions, and you can keep them coming in via the website, but poor, more than capable Laura, supposed to have had a day off. What, you didn't have a day off, did you? No, it's been busy. So what sort of things have been going on?
People were amazing this weekend. We had more interaction with us, really, than probably ever before.
Really?
Yeah, especially on Facebook and Twitter was amazing. People were getting out and about. They were doing the garden bio blitz at home.
Okay, yes.
They said no to the mow and left an area of grass to grow.
This isn't Mo Farrow. He hasn't done something bad.
This is a plant life scheme.
This is mowing, as in mowing a lawn.
Yes.
Don't mow the lawn. Okay, right.
And there were lots and lots of photos of stag beetles.
Oh, loads. Can we see any? Have we got any?
We have got one. Nick Hurrell.
I've seen it. Oh, look, not just one. That's four stag beetles for the price of one. Four male stag beetles. Now, this is a creature that's obviously got a very limited distribution in the UK, mainly in the southeast, but an absolute cracker. If you're lucky enough to live down there, keep an eye out for those. I used to find them underneath street lamps.
I've never seen one.
Yeah, underneath street lamps in built-up areas, particularly in Surrey. I've found it's a good place for stag beetles. And don't go riding your bicycle at night without a proper full-face mask, because one of those gets you in the eye when you're going home from the pub. It's an accident. Oh, yes. Well, I shouldn't encourage cycling. By the way, mustn't encourage cycling under the influence. Sorry. Moving on. Now, believe it or not, there were some quiet times. I'm trying my best, Laura. There were some quiet times over the weekend, weren't there? And our little mischievous story developers, and I've got some there, Joff, Maddie, Adam, Matt and Sam, you know who you are, started creating a bit of mischief of their own, didn't they?
They had a bit of fun with some hashtags, and they asked the audience to send in bird puns, bird names, based on bands and song names.
Now, this is your fault, OK? You, the audience, this is your fault. Now, let's have a look at some. We've got some over here. What have you got? Nine Finch Nails. Very good. I like that one. Thanks, Weird Bean. The Beatles. That's very good. I like what you're doing there. Nat King Cole Tit. Ringo Starling. Another Weird Bean one there. You obviously have got nothing else to do, Weird Bean, but that's brilliant.
If he comes back.
And Rolling Stone Curlews. That is fantastic. Those are the top ten. It's not quite ten, is it?
There's three more.
There's more.
Say, if we can.
Okay.
From Baggins Book Bazaar, there was I've Got You Under My Siskin.
Oh, brilliant.
No Egrets and Turnstone Cowboy.
Egrets, I've had a few.
Yeah.
Okay, brilliant. Okay, right. Sorry, that was terrible. Thank you very much, or not, for those, but we encourage you to interact with us. Right. Slow down, Nick. Getting excited. Got so much coming up in the show. Some crackers things on today. But we're going to start off with our quiz. Now, it's a bit different today. We haven't got the usual series of three or four mystery objects. We've got a sound quiz for you. But it's not any old sound quiz. We've slowed down the noise created by a common, widespread British creature. So have a little listen to this. Now, that has been slowed down. I don't know how many times, but we'll find out a little bit later on. Has anyone in the audience got any ideas what that might possibly be? R2-D2, Nightjar, when one's been slowed down. Steve Abbott, your reputation hinges on this. Any others? No, Nightjar? Nightjar's the best one so far.
Nightingale,
very good. I know where you're coming from. Brilliant. So, we want, if you think you know the answer, if you think you can beat our studio audience with those ideas, then do get in touch and let us know by the end of the show. Right. Now, we have got a very, very, and an extremely unusual special guest in the studio. Please welcome Jason Singh. Where are you, Jason?
Sorry.
Come and join me.
Great to see you, man.
Good to see you, too.
Do take a seat.
Thank you very much.
Do you fancy an egg case? Don't eat it.
No, right.
We're conscious. I'm just always rather curious, the things we have on this table.
Taste them.
Now, you are a sound sculptor.
Yes, of sorts.
Now, this is a thing, I don't even know what that is.
Okay.
Now, I'm assuming it involves sort of mimicking things? And
yeah. I use my voice and technology to mimic wildlife and forestry environments and instruments and a whole heap of other things.
So, do you do bird calls?
I do some bird calls.
Can you give us any?
I could do little beginnings of a blackbird.
Go on. Wow. Wow, do you just lie in bed in the morning and just impersonate what you can hear?
That's what I do. I get up and I just listen to birds and I go to sleep and listening to birds. That's just my life.
I mean, that's good, but we do. That's brilliant. That is brilliant. However, I know that our audience are pretty good at some bird impressions. You gave us a little go. Don't disappoint me now. Now, what can you do? Come on. Who was it who started this earlier on?
Oh, okay. Someone over there. There we go.
There's a tawny owl. There's a parliament of tawny owls. Very good. I can't. Are you impressed?
It's all happening.
They're pretty impressed, yeah. Yeah, you've got some students. All right, that's enough. That's enough. Now, I used to be able to do that. I can't do that. I think my thumbs have gone a bit weird. I can't actually seem to do that. But brilliant, brilliant stuff. Now, Gary, I need you here because this is very much in your field. So, Gary Moore, our wildlife sound recordist. The smartest wildlife sound recorders you'll ever see. Look at that. He's got the cravat on. He could have bought another one, Gary. You read that one last week. Now, to sort of understand how you get your inspiration, you have to go out and experience things first.
Absolutely.
So we thought we'd send you out with Gary Moore this morning to get a little bit of Minsmere inspiration.
Yep.
This is how they got on.
Right, Jason, what we'll do, we'll start off in woodland. It's quite a good place to start. We've just walked in here, and let's have a little listen and see what we've got. Why don't you plug your cans into there? A little listen. Sven's over here somewhere. You'll pick him. See if you can find him on there. When you hit the sweet spot, when you move around and you'll really find him. That's the wren. It's quite a complex song, isn't it? It's very long.
Yeah, it is.
Quite complex to learn. But once you've learned it, you'll never forget.
Yeah, it's very... Everything's so clear and detailed. So, internally... It's almost as though you can feel it. You can feel where those sounds are and where they're coming from.
All right, Jason, what we've done now is we've left the woodland, we've left that soft woodland, and we've come to what I think is quite a harsh, quite a scratchy environment. And I say that not just because of the birds that are here, but because of the wind in the reeds. That wind in the reeds can be a little bit almost at times. And here, I've got a reed warbler. Put your cans on. Out of that parabolic, and he'll start again in a minute.
Interesting how rhythmically things change from the woods out to out here.
Yeah.
You get these kind of, what you were saying before about scratchy sounds. Everything sort of feels a lot more high-pitched. So you've got the sharp...
Yeah.
Them sort of rhythms.
That's fantastic,
with sort of woody, reedy kind of, almost like brushing sonics.
Yeah.
It's incredible.
Yeah. The evolution has created the ability for that bird to do that just for love. I say how powerful, see? What we're all here for, isn't it, really,
to be
honest?
Spreading love.
Absolutely.
I like you, man. You're a cool guy.
Again, another totally different soundscape.
It's beautiful. It's so different rhythmically, isn't it? Everything just slows right down.
Yeah. All right, I know we've been carrying all this with us, the parabolic and the recorder and the cans, but you really don't need them, do you? Anybody can come and do this.
Absolutely.
You know?
Yeah, totally.
It's just letting the sound break over you or wash over you or and just opening your ears, isn't
Definitely.
It, really?
Definitely. It is really much about absorbing your environment, really just connecting with it.
So has my walk encouraged you to help create some of your own soundscapes?
It's totally blown me away, Gary. Can't wait. I can't wait to get back to the recording studio and get on it.
Excellent.
Cheers.
Wow. Now, I sense, I sense a bit of bromance there.
There's a bit of bromance.
You've got some chemistry. Some chemistry going on. Are you a little bit envious? Because you've got some nice toys you're going to show us later on. Yeah. Are you a bit envious of Gary's?
Definitely.
So what did listening to the world via Gary's equipment actually, how did that help you?
Just how direct it was, just to be able to point a microphone in a direction and just pinpoint sound from a particular place. That was just that experience is phenomenal. It's not something I've ever done before with microphones, and just to have that of, like, you know, literally, like you were saying, about finding the sweet spot of just, you know, tuning into something, and then just your focus is just incredible. Yeah, it's absolutely an incredible experience.
Now, I've still got no idea what goes on in your head when you've experienced this, but we're about to find out, because you actually have very little time to do this, bear in mind.
Yes,
and apparently you've come up with something rather special. So it's been suggested that you shut your eyes and listen to this. So, shall we see what you've got up to? Let's hear it. I haven't heard this before.
Okay.
I don't want to talk over it, but I have to. How? That's you doing all that?
Yeah. Yeah.
There's no birds in that at all. There's no recordings of birds. No, that's you doing that.
It's all based upon the inspiration of today, of kind of walking out, being part of an environment, and just mimicking it as much as I can. Not just bird song, but also the reverb and the wind and all those sort of textures.
That is amazing.
Cheers.
And apparently we've got yet more. You did a massive piece here, but we've got another movement. Listen to this.
Stars or beach.
That's you. It's not Gary recording the sound of the waves.
No.
It's clearly the waves on the shingle beach. How have you done this?
This is the thing of building up loads of layers of textures from those recordings, and just absorbing as much as I can, and then just, you know, getting to that place where you just sort of mimic. And
that's all with your voice.
It's all vocal.
But sampled. You've used some electronics as well. But
No, this is just your voice. It's layers and layers of my voice. So that's what you hear.
I knew something was going on. Every time I saw Jason today, he got squirreled away. It was a bit of a surprise for later, Nick. That is absolutely amazing.
Thank you very
much.
Now,
there was a bit of mischief going on. You were actually impersonating a bird. You actually called Gary out earlier, didn't you?
He did, absolutely.
So what did he do?
Yeah, well, I said there's a reverb over there, and I went, there's one over there. And I turned, he had a wry smile on his face, and he'd imitated the bird, completely caught me out. He's made my job redundant. I think I'm going to get my coat and go.
Well, that's pretty, pretty impressive. That's pretty impressive.
Nice
now, we were having a lot more from Jason a little bit later. We've got really, well, if that wasn't a treat enough, we've got a really special treat for a bit later on.